back with Junior Williams. Was I've Got You. How brilliant is that, Matt Everett? You liking that?
I like that a lot. It's very good. How are you?
I'm good. Excited as to what you've got in store.
Yeah, well, okay. So we've got, excuse me, a world-exclusive interview for you. Now is the first interview with Brian Molko from Placebo about Placebo's brand new music. Now, there's a lot to say here, but a lot more is about to be revealed. So in terms of Placebo, first of all, their last album... Loud Like Love was back in 2013. The last release was the single Jesus Son in 2016. But it's been a while, and this wait has been hugely frustrating for the band's fans, who are some of the most passionate of any fan base, many of whom have been following Brian and Stefan since their first single in 95 through 25 years and seven albums and some 13 million records sold. And there's been rumours of new music for a little bit, rumours that escalated somewhat as some possible tour dates for 2023 started to appear on social media. Those conversations started. Then on September 13th, there was a post that Placebo posted saying simply, "Beautiful James, September the 17th, accompanied by a photo of a billboard under a railway arch by a city road at night. This billboard's all black with the words Beautiful James just upon it. And then earlier today, Placebo tweeted the fact that there was going to be an interview with Brian on this very station, which has prompted lots of Twitter activity. It's been really lovely to see all Placebo's fans going, what is it? What is it? We want to hear from him. It's been so long. So we can confirm that Beautiful James is a new single, Placebo's first single in 5 years. And maybe most excitingly, Steve Lamacq is going to have the world exclusive first play of the single today here on Six Music on his show after 4 p.m. today. Brilliant exclusive to get from Steve. We're kind of assuming this is the opening salvo from a new album, but everything's kind of secret right now. But yeah, so to shine some light on this new music, also to talk about the process the band have engaged in to create the music, to talk a bit about Beautiful James and also what he's been doing over the past year and a half. Yesterday, just yesterday, I spoke to Brian Molko himself, and here he is. When was the last time you did an interview? Because it's been a while since we've heard from you, I believe.
It's got to be about 3 years. And one of the last ones I did was with you. But, I mean, I'm sure I've done a handful. I did a handful after that, but not very many. I'm nervous. I mean, I don't think I've ever been nervous. And now after, like, this pause, I'm finding everything that I was used to being new and nerve-wracking to me. So it's different. I don't know how I feel about it, but it's different.
Is this you sort of emerging from the butterfly cocoon, a little bit sensitive to the light?
I wish I'd done what Stefan did, which was go to the gym 3 times a week during lockdown to keep himself sane. I just went, oh, well, there are about... There's got to be at least 25 series of Doctor Who. I really need to reacquaint myself with every single episode. So that's kind of what I did. I watched every episode of Doctor Who available.
That was your major achievement of lockdown. Brilliant.
Yes. Yeah, you know, I can go on Celebrity Mastermind now, you know.
So, like, this new track, and, I mean, was this planned to be happening, like, before? Tell me a bit about the kind of timescale and how things got shifted around.
Well, in January, February 2020, we were basically ready to go on tour. The album was almost finished, and we'd spent 2019 in our home studio working on it. You know, we'd sort of decided already that Beautiful James would be the first single. So we had a lot of confidence and we had a lot of kind of get up and go. And then obviously what happened. And so everything's kind of delayed by about 2 years now.
That's a long time to be sitting on something, isn't it?
It is, but it's better to be... I feel like a penguin or something sitting on an egg, you know. Kind of thing. I think it's better to have an egg to sit on, you know, than to not, you know. Yeah. So I think that maybe having that egg, you know, and knowing however frustrating it was, you know, like, oh, another wait. As I know, it was frustrating for the fans, but, you know, it was equally, well, I don't know, equally, but certainly very frustrating for us as well, kind of the interminable wait to put out new music, but, you know, at least it was there. So we knew we had it. Yeah.
You just said, you said the word confident there. Were the sessions really invigorating? Did you, were you aware that you were doing something that you were, you know, that was fully realized, that you were really, really happy with?
Well, we don't make it easy on ourselves. I have what I would describe as a boredom problem. Stefan has often said that he's never met anybody with a lower boredom threshold than myself. And that really kind of, it influences and informs the way that we work. This time I came to Stefan with images first. I want to do everything backwards, so let's choose an album cover before we write any music.
That's really interesting.
Here's a list of song titles, which I've been writing over the past 5 years. Let's start with these song titles instead of starting with the music. Let's do everything backwards. Let's do everything that we do last, first. Let's do this whole album without a drummer, because there's been a drummer on every album so far. There's just me and you now in the studio. Let's just do it, me and you. In the end, we ended up using two drummers, you know, kind of thing. And of course, this kind of backwards way of working kind of floated away as the process started. But it very much informed kind of this sort of break with the process and the way that you would normally approach everything. I just needed to do it backwards at the beginning just to kind of feel like I was doing something different. When I wake up, I'm soaking in my sheets. Breathe, breathe, believe, 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 believe.
Okay. Let's talk about Beautiful James, which we're going to hear for the first time later today on Steve Lamacq's show. Tell me about, where did this one come from? Tell me a bit about its realization.
Well, like I said, it was earlier when I was talking about presenting song titles to songs that hadn't been written. You know, I had this list of song titles, and that was one of them, and for some reason it just kind of jumped out of the page at me, you know, and it made itself known. But it kind of started during a period of major insomnia for me in 2019. I was having this kind of, I mean, I have issues with sleep, and I can sort of go through periods where for a couple of months, I don't really get more than 2 or 3 hours sleep a night. And this was a particularly bad, you know, couple of weeks, but in my kind of stupor, I was getting kind of, I don't know where from, but kind of melodies and phrases were kind of coming into my head. It was like I was kind of delirious, you know, from lack of sleep, and therefore connected to something which I didn't really know what it was. But these things were just coming into my head. And I remember having to sort of get out of bed like 5-6 times a night, even though I wasn't sleeping, and just go over to the piano and record a melody onto my phone. And one of those melodies was called Bad Piano, because I'd recorded it at like 5 in the morning, you know, just to get the notes down. And so for a long time, Beautiful James was called Bad Piano, because the initial, the main hook melody was written by me at 5 o'clock in the morning, in the middle of a major bout of insomnia. And then Stefan had to take it and make some sense out of it. And it became the keyboard riff, the main riff of Beautiful James. I really want each person who cares enough to listen to the record to find their own story. So Beautiful James, I fully expect people to ask me all the time, who is Beautiful James? Who is Beautiful James? Well, I don't know. Who's your favorite James? James Corden or James Brown? Which one do you prefer? Or like, you know, who is James to you? You know, and is James even a man? These are questions I'm not going to answer. These are questions I want people to ask themselves. We are loud like love.
absolutely fantastic. And Brian Molko, such a lovely guy, isn't he?
I know, it's amazing to speak to him. Thank you so much for doing that, Brian. I mean, who is your favourite James? I mean, James L. Jones is pretty cool. James Brown's pretty cool. I'm making it slightly more flippant than it needs to be. But yeah, it was wonderful to speak to him. And the most important thing is you can hear that track, Beautiful James, for the very first time on Steve Lamacq's show here on Six Music from 4 p.m. today. So check it out, because they're a brilliant band, you know?
Yep, couldn't agree more. Thank you very much, Matthew.
Speak to you tomorrow.
Is your classic haunted house?
Yeah. On BBC iPlayer.
They scared me.
Everything scare you?
You'd be scared of a teddy bear if it spoke. Actually, that is quite scary.
A brand new series of the BAFTA-nominated comedy.
At last!
You didn't laugh. Nobody laughed!